Track and field update with the head coach, Rod DeHaven, wrapping up the Summit League Championships and looking forward to postseason competition. Let's talk about things in Tulsa. Before we delve into the results, we had discussed going into it, the heat, the humidity, how that might impact things. What sort of an impact did the weather have on the event?
Well, I think largely the heat and humidity was handled pretty well by the student athletes from all schools. Yeah, there was the occasional injury, but I think you see that whether it's 40 degrees or 90 degrees. I think it's just that point in the season where the student athlete's going to put out such a tremendous effort because it's a championship event. That being said, you know, I thought that, you know, all in all, our effort was really good. And starting off with the women, you know, to get the number of individual championships we did, you know, we're quite happy with that. Certainly want to climb the team standings and get closer to the top as we progress here in the next couple of years. But for Vanessa Lane to win the heptathlon in her last you know, track meet as a jackrabbit, that was pretty cool. Casey Vollmer, you know, having her biggest throw of the season to win the discus. Rachel King, really a really controlled effort to win the steeplechase, was really solid. And then Krista Steele's 800 was you know, almost identical to what happened indoors, and you know, certainly nice to see that. So you know, for the women, I think, you know, it's still a pretty young group. I think we can be better. You know, we put one or two people that were dinged up into the lineup, and certainly we're third. And I, you know, really see with the mix of people we have coming in next year that we can, you know, point wise, you know, start to close that gap on the first two leagues in the conference. So you know, for where we're at right now, I think, you know, pretty solid. On the men's side, unbelievable meet, really. I mean, you look at the number of school records, the way our athletes competed, and you know, just, you know, the projected number of points we had going into the meet and what we finish up with. And I think projected maybe we were 164, and that was probably, I thought, maybe even a little high, you know, based because some of the 10K stuff, not a lot of people had run a 10K before. And then we end up with 215. It just says so much about how our guys came out and competed, and really, you know, from the get-go with Evan Heber going 9 out of 10 and personal best, and then setting the school record in the decathlon, the 10K guys coming out and going 1, 2, 3. And then on Saturday, to start the meet by winning the 4x1, and then, you know, really just kind of flipping the script, because that's an event that USD typically is going to win and has done very well in. And then our guys were able to do that, break the school record. I think it provided a lot of adrenaline for the group across the board. And then we get immediately, almost right after that, we get nice performance from Kyle Burdick. We get some probably bonus points in the hurdles. And, you know, just kind of keeps rolling. Skylar Monahan, you know, scoring pretty high in the 400, which wouldn't have projected that. And then the 800, we knew we were going to get a lot of points out of that. And that's something we, on Friday, going through that prelim and getting all those guys to the final, we knew we had that in our back pocket. But, you know, really an unbelievable performance from our men. And, you know, to have that many school records in one meet is pretty phenomenal. Great facility in terms of, you know, being able to take advantage of the sprints and jumps. And, you know, Bryant Quarters, you know, two big jumps. You know, yes, the 26-1 is wind-aided. You know, I think I've mentioned that a lot of people can't probably jump 26-1 being dropped out of a plane. And, you know, that was huge. And then he comes back the next day in the triple jump and goes almost 52 feet, breaking Sam Harris's, you know, 30-some, almost 40-year-old record, or I'm a math minor, I can't remember. But, you know, it, you know, great performance from him. And then Daniel Clark breaking the school record in the 100. And, you know, really emerging as an athlete and having a great long jump as well. So it was, yeah, I think just a really good way to, you know, finish for a lot of the young men on the team. And hopefully, you know, we kind of bridge that gap outdoors to North Dakota State a little bit. We know that inherently because of the throws, they, particularly the long throws, you know, they've really been able to, you know, put a lot of distance between other schools and themselves with those events. And, you know, we've got to keep getting better there and hopefully continue to close that gap.
It is impressive, the individual recognitions on the men's side to sweep those honors that were handed out on Saturday.
Yeah, for Kyle Burdick to be athlete of the meet, and I don't know that it was, you know, maybe his A game that particular weekend. I think, you know, with another guy in the lead from the 800, I'm not sure his effort was, you know, 100%, but still pretty solid. And that 10K took more out of him maybe this year than it did last year. But his 1500 in those conditions that time was pretty solid, and And I think sets him up as we head into his first round of the NCAAs.
Speaking of the NCAAs, off to Sacramento, 9 going in all, correct?
Yeah, 9. That's a number that a little less than last year. I think that's okay. When you look at it, we have a really solid group going with some, I think a handful of people that have a chance to advance on it. Eugene, and that's what it's all about. It's not for the tourists. This is a survive and advance, purely. And we look at it. You look at Bryant Quarter, sits 13th in the triple jump, top 12 go. He's got to obviously bring his A game and then hope that he can beat one guy and advance there. Rachel King, the West is uber competitive in a lot of the distance races, and she sits in the top 10. I think she has a good chance to advance. Casey Vollmer was also close last year in the discus, and even though she may not be ranked super high, I think she's putting things together at the right time, and we'll have a decent chance to advance as well. Kyle Burdick, who did advance last year, is not going to come in super high on the performance list, but largely that doesn't mean anything, because typically the 1500s end up being very, very tactical, and I think Kyle's in a good place for that. Certainly, not over-raced, and hopefully very energized for this competition. And Trent Francombe, who sits in the mid-20s, the pole vault is another event where the nerves of this competition, knowing that it's not so much, you're not necessarily trying to win, you're trying to make bars. As a freshman, he may not even pay attention to what's going on, and just, if he can pop over one more bar and basically, get in that 17.6 range, he has a chance to go. So that's pretty exciting. And Krista Steele, who's her first time around, I think if she can advance around and get that experience and set herself up maybe in year 4 to have a great chance. And Colton Bender, he's been there before, threw well last year. If he can up his PR by 10 feet, stranger things have happened. And Mason Lyseth, who gets in the last, because of a scratch or two in the shot put, just gets another chance to extend his athletic career, and I think he's got more in the bank too, and we're excited to have him along on this trip. And then Daniel Clark running that 100, we can see him lower his school record as well. So really excited about this group, and we fully believe that our season is going to extend with at least a couple athletes on to Eugene, and it's cap off what has been really a really good spring considering the weather and all the crazy travel and everything else that's gone on.
You've had a lot to contend with. To wrap it up, going back to what you alluded to, that this isn't just for tourists, this is a challenging event, trying to get to Eugene. What does it take? Having been an athlete who has succeeded yourself in situations like this, obviously you've coached a number of them. What does it take in an event like this to get to Eugene?
Well, again, I kind of alluded to some events, and for those that don't know how the NCAA track and field works at the Division I level, basically the country is split in half. You have a West region and an East region, and largely the West region is composed of Power 5 conferences, the western half of the Big Ten, Big 12, Pac-12, your Mountain West, which all have pretty solid track programs, and you have an independent in BYU that is ranked in the top 10 in the country. So some of the events are just crazy hard, where you could be literally 10th in this region and you might be 12th in the whole country. And then you just look at the how track and field has gone this year, that some of the all-time records have been set. The indoor national meet was crazy, and that has extended the outdoor season. So an opportunity for our kids to line up with some of the, not only the best in college, but really the best in the world. And that is what I think the Division I experience is all about. When we got into this almost 15 years ago, I think that is why we're doing this, to compete and measure South Dakota State against the very best, and in this case it is the very best in the world. And you have to bring your A game, and if you're not, you're going to go home. Now, as far as getting through, it is managing emotions, being ready at the right time, not getting thrown off by a different venue, slightly different procedures in terms of how you're going to check in, warm up, and all that sort of stuff. But fortunately, a lot of these kids have been through this before, and we expect some big things. And like a Rachel King, who was so close in cross country last fall to making it, and she's been a little bit snake bitten during the track season. This is her third trip to the regionals. I think she, really believes that, this is it. She's going to get through and then have, an All-American type performance in Eugene when she does get through.